God aften og velkommen til den 11. time. I aftens udsendelse har vi den amerikanske filminstruktør David Lynch som gæst. Han er, efter min mening, en af de vigtigste og mest interessante filminstruktører i verden i dag. Man kan jo bare sige Eraserhead, The Elephant Man, Wild at Heart, Blue Velvet, Twin Peaks, Lost Highway. Fantastisk. Det var sådan, at sidste gang David Lynch var i Danmark, var der en masse journalister, der fik lov at interviewe ham. Bagefter gik de på druk, for de havde regnet med at møde det her Hollywood-ikon, og i stedet for mødte de en mand, der gerne ville tale om meditation. Og vi kan lige så godt sige det, som det er. David Lynch er inviteret til Danmark af Højskolen for Bevidsthedsudvikling. Den ligger i Rørvig. Det er et større fiskeleje lige over for Hundested ved Sjællands Odde. Og derfor er der også nogle betingelser for, at vi kan interviewe ham her i aften. Rektoren for højskolen, Ole Blenkow, er med i studiet, og vi skal først og fremmest tale om meditation. Det har jeg sagt ja til, og derfor skal jeg også fortælle om den bog, som David Lynch har udgivet, hvor han for første gang fortæller om sin fascination for meditation. Han har dyrket og været optaget af at meditere i over 30 år, og bogen, den hedder Catching the Big Fish. Så nu kan vi så sige, at i den 11. time, der møder Hollywood Rørvig.
Hej Ole.
Velkommen.
Hej
Michael.
Hej Michael.
Welcome to the 11th hour.
Thanks a lot.
Let's start talking about meditation. Ole, hvor mange år har du mediteret?
33.
You've been meditating for 33 years?
Ja, men man gør det kun to gange dagligt, så jeg har også lavet andre ting.
You've been meditating for
33 years.
That's a coincidence.
Talking to Uli, he's 5 months ahead of me, though. We started in February.
Okay. I've never been meditating at all. I know nothing about it. So you have to help me.
Can I help you?
Yeah, because, you know, I
you don't know about it.
No, and I haven't slept much last night because I got a little starstruck.
Yes, okay, now, Michael, I'm going to tell you just a little bit about transcendental meditation. There's many, many forms of meditation.
Yeah, but you also have to help me get through this interview.
Uh-huh. But what would you like?
To relax?
Yeah.
Oh. You should take a course in meditation.
Yeah. But can we start about talking about meditation? How did you start out?
I'll tell you. I grew up in the northwest of the United States, I never heard the word meditation. Then maybe when I was in art school, I started hearing about meditation, but I thought it was a waste of time. And I had zero interest in meditation. Then I heard a phrase, true happiness is not out there, true happiness lies within. And I start thinking about that it has some truth to it. But they don't tell you where the within is, nor do they tell you how to get there. And then I started thinking, maybe meditation is that way to go within, to go within. And maybe the source of that real happiness is within. And so I started looking into meditation.
But what did you do? You just...
I went to... my sister called and said she had started transcendental meditation, coincidentally. What she told me about it, I liked the sound of it. I liked the information. But more than that, I heard a change in her voice, more self-assured, more happiness that I'd not ever heard before. And I said, this is it. And I went down to the center and I met my teacher. I asked all the questions I needed to ask, got the answers I needed, and I started. And what I say in this book is, my first meditation, I did not know what was going to happen. And then suddenly, I've been given my mantra. I'm taking to a little room to do my first meditation, told to sit down comfortably, close the eyes, start that mantra. They teach you the mantra and they teach you how to use the mantra. And away I went. And as I say, it was as if I was in an elevator and they cut the cable.
Okay.
Boom. Unbelievable, unique, powerful, yet very familiar, but so unique and sublime experience. And I said, this is amazing. This is the real thing. And I've been going twice a day for 33 years since then.
So you've done it today?
Done it this morning, for sure.
Where?
In the hotel.
Okay. You too, Ole?
Yes, in my home. I live in Copenhagen.
Okay. Yes. But in your book, you say that meditation can be done anytime, anywhere.
You can meditate any place. Now, that the reason...
In airports?
Yes, anywhere.
But
anywhere.
Also in the television studios?
In the television studios.
You can?
Yes.
Could you meditate during this interview?
Yes, but it would look very boring to the viewers because you dive within. You take the attention away from the outer world. You take the attention to the inner world. And once the attention is gone, there's not much entertainment.
Men Ole, ville du kunne gøre det,
sure,
mens vi taler?
Ja. Det vil jeg kunne.
Jamen, kan vi gøre det?
Jamen, jeg kan ikke være to steder på en gang. Enten så har man opmærksomheden indad, og så er den der, 100%, eller også så er den ude. Meditation er en forberedelse til at have den ude, for når man har den inde, så bliver den meget stærk, og så kan man vende den ud af stærkere.
Men vil du kunne gøre det, mens jeg taler med David Lynch?
Det vil jeg kunne. Men skal som sagt, jeg har gjort det i dag.
Skal vi prøve?
Okay, 3 minutter.
Okay, så snakker vi videre.
Okay.
Godt. Og hvordan gør du så? Du sætter dig bare?
Man sætter sig behageligt til rette. Og så lukker man øjnene. Og så starter man ind i hovedet en mental teknik. Så man prøver ikke at dirigere kroppen på nogen som helst måde. Men når sindet falder til ro, så følger kroppen med.
Kan vi sige 5 minutter? Fordi så vil jeg lige spørge ham om noget.
Okay, men jeg vil sandsynligvis ikke vide, hvad der er foregået.
Det er også okay.
Er det okay?
Ja, det er fint nok.
Det er en deal.
Ja.
Okay. Jeg tager lige en slap.
Ja. Do you like your coffee?
I haven't had any yet. I'm about ready to have a great cappuccino because I had one earlier and it was sensational.
You know, the man behind this coffee is the world champion.
This is proof that he is.
What is your relation to coffee?
I've been loving coffee for many, many years, since I was about 3. And
you started as a 3-year-old coffee drinker?
Well, probably earlier, but I don't remember much before then. But I'm loving coffee, and especially cappuccinos these days. And this is one of the best cappuccinos I've ever had.
It's true? You mean that?
I really do mean it.
The world champion is a Danish man called Troels. You met him before?
I just met him.
And he became the world champion in Seattle.
Uh-huh. Home of Starbucks.
Yeah. Can you describe the coffee?
There's no bitterness in it. There's no sugar in it, yet it's very sweet. It's smooth. It has a